From Nashville, Tennessee, it's Country Music Time, brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Now here's the star of this week's show, Kenny Starr.
It's good to be back to a real honky-tonk, and that good old Texas two-step they call the Texas Stomp. They're a little bit rowdy, and they like their music loud, but they're my kind of people, my kind of corral. And there's no place like Texas, and being Texas proud.
Kenny Starr, welcome to Country Music Time.
Thank you very much, Pete. Glad to be here.
You just sang some of my favorite kind of music.
I like that, too.
The Texas two-step, the twin fiddles.
Thank you very
much. That's really hot nowadays, isn't it?
It is, and that song, though, was recorded really before the two-step became as popular as it is nowadays.
Yeah, with the advent of Urban Cowboy and all that sort of stuff.
That's right.
You don't strike me as a country entertainer. You look more like an intern. You know that?
An intern.
A young doctor.
No, I've never heard that one before.
You dress sharp. You look sharp. That's great.
Well, thank you very much.
Do you perform on stage dressed the way you are right now?
Yes, I do.
I think it suits your image. A gentleman with class.
Well, thank you.
Your music has class, too. Of course, you're best known up to now for your song, The Blind Man in the Bleachers.
Right.
And we'll be listening to that later on. We'll talk about it later on.
Great.
But you've recently written a song and a score for a movie concerning the search for the Titanic.
That's correct. It has to do with the adventure of the Texas oil man, Jack Grimm, out of Abilene, Texas. But anyway, the song, that boiling it down to the song, The Ballad of the Titanic, tells about the haunting, terrible episode that happened on April 14th, 1912. It was a disastrous adventure.
Well, except for the mention in your biography that you composed the score for the movie, it makes no other mention of you being a songwriter.
Oh, I see. Well, I've written, I think I've written several songs. I don't know what the wording is in the bio, but I've written songs for like Farron Young and Loretta Lynn, of course, and Conway Twitty. And Mel Tellis through the another movie, The Villain. I was a part writer in a song for Columbia Pictures, The Villain. So I've done a little bit of songwriting, but it's not as well known as a lot of other things are.
Well, in 20 words or less, how did you get involved with Loretta Lynn Show?
Well, I entered a talent contest when I was 17 in Wichita, Kansas, and one of the judges was a promoter for a country music show. Uh-huh. And I won the contest. He approached me and said, would you like to be a guest on Loretta's show?
Are you kidding?
And I said, you better believe it. Yeah. So 2 days later, I appeared on her show when she came to Wichita and then Kansas City, Kansas. And she said, well, if you ever get a chance to come to Nashville and I'll try to help you
and
out.
And so you made it.
2 days later, I was in Nashville,
Absolutely.
Tennessee.
Absolutely. Right. That's a storybook situation
it
there.
It is.
Very lucky for you. Of course, you deserve it because you're a very talented gentleman.
Well, thank you very much, Pete. It was a dream come true, and Loretta Lynn is a great lady.
Why don't we listen now to the Ballad of the Titanic?
All right, and I might add that this is narrated and also co-written with a good friend of mine, Craig Deitchman. So okay. He's the narrator.
It was a cold, dark night in history. A great ship riding an icy sea, threading her way to New York town. Struck a berg that took her down.
Way down beneath the cold Atlantic, way on down.
All the passengers in panic.
The unsinkable ship Titanic took a voyage to history.
She took 1,500 helpless people
down beneath the sea.
It was just before midnight, steaming westward as she called, her big foghorn a-wailing, her steel hull double wall.
Iceberg ahead!
Cried the frightened watchman. Thank you, that's all he said. 30 seconds later, all the people were awakened to the sound of metal ripping, the double hull a-breaking. The Titanic, she was shaking. The water she was taking said she had to be forsaken. Sinking, no mistaking.
Taking 1,500 helpless people
down beneath the sea. We're gonna find the Titanic in her cold and lonely grave. Yes, we'll find the Titanic with her cowards and her brave.
We've all been told the story of the tragedy and glory of that great ship Titanic at the bottom of the sea. You can feel how scared they must have been as they heard the water pouring in. Find the lifeboat, send them down. Not enough to go around.
Way down beneath the cold Atlantic, way on down.
All the passengers in panic.
The unsinkable ship Titanic took a voyage to history.
She took 1,500 helpless people
down beneath the sea.
The hull was fractured, walls were broken. There were people dying, some were crying, hoping they stayed upon it, though her decks were sloping, and the band was bravely playing.
Nearer, my God, to thee.
We're gonna find the Titanic in her cold and lonely grave.
Yeah, we'll find the Titanic with her cowards and her brave.
That great ship Titanic at the bottom of the sea.
We're gonna find the Titanic in her cold and lonely grave. Yeah, we'll find the Titanic with her cowards and her brave.
We've all been told the story of the tragedy and glory of that great ship Titanic at the bottom of the sea.
The U.S. Air Force needs people to help it protect the wild blue yonder over our great country. And we're especially interested in those who have previously served in any of the military services within the past 5 years. The Air Force also has a limited number of retraining opportunities for prior service people. There are many more reasons to be part of the Air Force. Your local recruiter can tell you all about it.
Thank you. just the blind man in the bleachers to the local hometown fans. And he sits beneath the speakers way back in the stands. And he listens to the play-by-play waiting for one name. He wants to hear his son get in the game. But the boy's just not a hero, he's strictly second team. Though he runs each night for touchdowns in his father's sweetest dreams, he's gonna be a star someday, though you might never tell. But the blind man in the bleachers knows he will. And the last game of the season is a Friday night at home, and no one knows the reason, but the blind man didn't come. And his boy looks kinda nervous, sometimes turns around and stares, just as though he sees the old man sitting there. The local boys are trying, but they slowly lose their will. Another player's down, and now he's carried from the field. At halftime in the locker room, the kid goes off alone, and no one sees him talking on the phone. And the game's already started when he gets back to the team, and half the crowd can hear his coach yell, "Where the hell you been?" Just getting ready for the second half is all he'll say, 'cause now you're gonna let me in to play. And without another word, he turns and runs into the game. And through the silence on the field, loudspeakers call his name. It'll make the local papers how the team came from behind when they saw him playing out his heart to win. When the game was over, the coach asked him to tell, what was it he was thinking of that made him play so well? Well, you knew my dad was blind, he said. Well, tonight he passed away. It's the first time that my father's seen me play.
Well, Kenny, I guess up to now, that is what you are best known for, the song The Blind Man in the Bleachers.
That's right.
That's a true story, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It's a true story. It was written by Sterling Whipple, and Sterling came from Oregon. I was in church, and the preacher had his sermon based on the story of the blind man in the bleachers. Well, Sterling went home that day and wrote the song, and when he came to Nashville, he pitched it around, and it never got recorded until I came up with it. But I come to find out after I recorded the thing that it was in Reader's Digest in 1950.
Well, listen, continued success to you, and especially with your movie score and the single with The Search for the Titanic. Hope to see a lot more good music coming from you.
Well, I thank you very much, Pete, and it's been a pleasure being here. Thank you.
Country Music Time was recorded live in Nashville, Tennessee, and was brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Technical direction by Chuck Hawsey, engineering by Bill Vornick. This is Air Force Sergeant Pete Franquette saying thanks again to Kenny Starr and reminding you to contact your local Air Force recruiter to get details about the Air Force experience. It could be your ticket to a great way of life.